The leader of opposition, Mafia Simpoga, led the opposition members of parliament today to the damaged section of Kampala Masaka Road, which was washed away by River Katonga, which busted its banks on Thursday last week. Mpoga was overwhelmed by the damage on this highway and asked the Uganda National Roads Authority to provide a temporary bridge which can accommodate pedestrians, motorbikes and light vehicles in the meantime as they work out a plan for comprehensive restoration of the bridge.
Our prayer is that UNRWA would come up with a temporal arrangement to create a temporary bridge, motorable bridge, to at least transport persons and light merchandise.
The leader of opposition faulted government for ignoring the recommendation of the 10th parliament, which called for a halt of sand mining and farming in Katonga and Rela wetlands, which activities, according to him, have damaged the ecosystem to result into floods.
People know that people mining sand in Rela have no restoration or decommissioning program to restore the environment. The rice growers are expanding from bounds to bounds, are interfering with the ecosystem, and nature is fighting back. I hope we are going to see correctional measures to ensure that the damage visited on the environment is halted and restoration made.
Area leaders, including the vice chairperson of Mpiji District, Aisha Nachirija, and the Mawokota South legislator, Yusuf Nsibambi, have explained devastating effects of the road breakdown, saying most people can no longer cross to access markets and health services.
We have been having referrals Kampala and Masaka, so people, they can no longer go to Masaka for medical checkups as they have been doing.
I think this is a wake-up call. It should be addressed, otherwise we shall have so many incidents. It has affected the economy locally here. We don't have access. People are supposed to go to school and hospitals, no access. Even the international highway has been interfered. It's a very big embarrassment to the nation.
The situation is worse on the alternative road of Kabula Soke Vira Maria Masaka Road, which was equally washed away by River Katonga floods. This affected the road section in Gomba District. People use canoe boats to cross and each person is charged 10,000 shillings to cross the bridge. By the time the leader of opposition and his delegation reached the area, carpenters were busy making more canoes to save the situation. Mpoga committed to press government to commence civil works as early as possible to save people's businesses which have crippled because of damages on the road.
Pray that the subsequent civil works will take care of the fact that we need serious civil engineering to improve this road, enhance access to this economic subzone, and also encourage the farmers this far.
It's so sad that the women in particular have been affected because they have been earning a living from these roadsides.
In a press statement posted on their Twitter account, UNRWA has revealed that the emergency works on River Katonga along the Kampala Masaka Highway will be complete in 3 weeks. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.
Yeah.